am Neha Kumari, TYBCOM student from Sydenham College. Today, on behalf of Sydenham Alumni Cell, today we are interviewing our prominent alumni, CA Ketan Dalal. Sir, in which batch you passed out from Sydenham College?
I passed out in 1977, so I was in the batch from 73 to 77. It used to be a four-year course at that point in time.
So can I ask you some questions about your Sydenham life and your career life? Everything you have encountered in life has something to teach. So tell me what Sydenham has taught you.
See, these are clearly the college years, Vega, our formative years. And of course, in my case, it is 45 years ago. So it's, you know, difficult to remember the full details. But Sydenham now, as well as at that time, it used to be literally the number one commerce college in the western part of India. Possibly in the whole of India, and the quality of the people I interacted with was a phenomenal learning experience, both in terms of the students and in terms of the professors. I mean, clearly it taught me, it laid the foundation, it clearly laid the foundation for what I am today.
What do you admire most about the Sydenham College?
Again, as I mentioned to you, you know, at the end of the day, you learn from the people around you and the quality of the people I interacted with, because you see the technical knowledge and all that you can probably go to another college and get it, but the quality of the interaction, the quality of the relations, some of the relations endure till today. So the quality of the interaction and the quality of the relationships is most important, because as I said, the technical content in any field you can learn from different colleges as well. But what distinguishes certain institutions from others is what I just mentioned to you, the quality of the people, both in terms of the professors as well as in terms of yes.
What was the most contributing experience to your being in this field?
I assume you mean the chartered accountancy field. Well, at that time we didn't have that many choices. You know, today you have probably, somebody was telling me the other day that you probably have the choice of between 3 to 3,500 careers. We never had anything like this. Today you can even think of becoming an aeronautical engineer, space, etc. We had very limited choices. What I think at that stage happened, my father is a CA, was a CA, he passed away. My father was a CA. So it was somehow a natural transition from my school to my college, commerce, because that's a, you can become a science graduate and become a CA, but the usual course would be through a BCom degree. And then it was just natural that I would walk into the profession in which my father had built a name, some name for himself. You know. So that was the reason. There was no scientific reason why I wound up in this particular course.
Okay. What would you advise to our students who are currently pursuing CA or are thinking to pursue CA?
You know, I would like to sort of deal with this question with a different mindset.
Okay.
I would like to sort of step back and see. Mm-hmm. First of all, the person has to like what he does.
True.
If you like what you do, you probably will excel at it. You know, as opposed to what I would call a forced fitment, I have seen enough, fortunately it didn't happen in my case, but I have seen very many situations of people who sort of pre-decide that this is the field I am going to take. Then they find that they don't like this. They have not applied their mind to alternative, you know, sources, alternative careers. So I think the first point to your question of what would you like to advise, first find out whether you are really, what does being a CA mean? Today, unlike before, so earlier it used to be, you know, audit and tax, even in the CA profession. Today, there are 10 types of audits and tax has got 20 types of meanings. Are we talking of, you know, being an indirect tax specialist, are we tax specialist, are we talking of being a transfer pricing specialist? Then there is a whole consulting field.
Yes.
So, you know, even being a CA by itself doesn't mean anything. You know, it's like, see, earlier, and you are very young people, so when I remember in my days when we used to go for say dinner and just used to think of dinner, and the choices used to be Rajasthani food or North Indian food.
Or South Indian something.
Maybe South Indian food. Today, the minute you say, you tell a friend that I want to go for dinner, Do you want to go for Lebanese? Do you want to go for Mexican? Do you want to go for Oriental? Within Oriental, you want to go for Japanese? Similarly, today, everything has become very specialized. So being a CA means nothing by itself. You need to sort of, and of course, many of you will be not very clear about it, but you can ask around, is to say, it appears that I want to do this ultimately, and there I think CA course helped me to do this, and therefore should I do the CA course.
Yes.
That kind of, you know, introspection, research, due diligence, thinking has to go in, and it probably applies not only to CA but to any other field.
Yes.
So I would like to sort of the answer it the way I have. It is to broad base this whole concept and think of it, you know.
Basically, the CA also got many bifurcations in itself.
Correct. But you know, so what may happen while going into that, you may start realizing that, oh, I think MBA is better for me.
Uh-huh.
Or oh, CFA is better for me. Maybe. I'm not saying it is.
Oh.
CA is a very good course, but you have to think what you want to become and then see. See, okay, so let me slightly modify, not modify, supplement my answer. You know, it's like saying that this is what I want to be or I think I want to be. So first figure out that. And then say, see, let me look at a qualification as a tool to get there. If I want to reach there, is this the right ladder or it is not? That's the way I think.
So what will be your message to our fellow Sydenhamites?
So one of the things is what I just mentioned to you, that life is becoming very, very competitive. It's becoming very tough. Very competitive, and there are a lot of smart people. So you need to find out, as I said, what you like, what you excel at, what is your distinguishing feature. Because if you are just becoming like everybody else, then there is no distinguishing feature. So you need to first find out what are your special skills and try and excel at those skills if you want to make a successful life. The second issue is, as I just mentioned, the choice of a career is extremely critical. The third point I want to make is that, you know, when you build friendships or when you continue friendships as, you know, people who will be leaving college, for example, try and build deep, enduring, sustainable relationships, because these relationships will very often take you far. Try and be in touch with more intelligent people. If you are, it will keep adding value to your life. And the last point which I want to make Meta is, there is no substitute for hard work. There is just no substitute. You know, just winding away time in some of these activities, and I know that social media takes a lot of time, and I am not against social media. I think it has a very important role. But restrict the time on things like that. For example, spend time in, you know, more intense reading, for example. I'm not saying one should not enjoy, but these sort of combinations, there has to be a balance in all this. I think these are some of the messages that I thought would be useful.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for taking your time for us, and thank you so much.
Thank you.